Good morning and Suprabhat. I'm very much thankful to the organizers for such a beautiful conference in Pune. And I'm again thankful for the opportunity which you have given us to come in front of large gathering of dermatologists. As we know, skin is the largest organ of the human body, and most of the dermatologists has got a big load of diseases because of increasing the spectrum of the dermatological diseases. The increased spectrum of dermatological diseases is because of lot of awareness in the public. There are use of cosmetics, everyday cosmetics use has increased, and there are lot of environmental hazards which has increased the dermatological disease spectrum. As we know, skin is the mirror of human body, and whatever is taking place inside the human body is somehow, anyhow, it is displayed in the form of some change on the human skin. At many times, if some disease is developing inside the body, it presents with a skin change, and even many physicians send cases to the dermatologist for the diagnosis of some internal disease to which they are not able to elicit by a clinical examination. Even surgeons, there are so many malignancies or tumors inside body, if they are developing, they have got some changes in the skin disease. As I told, skin is a visual disease, dermatological diagnosis is a visual diagnosis, but there are diagnostic tests which are done in dermatology, and the most common is skin biopsy. And beside that, there are certain advanced tests in case it is not diagnosed by a biopsy by immunohistopathology. There are some certain serological tests like ELISA or PCR. Now, because of the emergence of new molecules in the world market in the treatment of dermatological disease, the load to the dermatologist has increased in the form of adverse drug reaction. Dr. Lalit, because we see every time a new rash after use of certain drug. So what is your opinion about it?
Yes. So good morning, everybody. I am Dr. Lalit Kumar Gupta. I am working as a professor at the Government Medical College, Udaipur, and I'm working in the fields of drug reaction for past so many years. We have come out with a textbook, which is an Indian-centric textbook on the field of drug reactions, and it's a very useful resource for all our countrymen. Now, as you said, the emergence of newer and newer drugs has really put a lot of challenge amongst the dermatologists to diagnose the ill effects of these drugs. Now, when we talk about the reactions to the drugs, we must realize that it is not only the oral medication that the patient takes, but it is also the medication that the patient applies on the skin. Now, we all know that hardly there is a possibility that the patient, as a first time visit, will come to the dermatologist.
Yes.
Initially, the patient will go to quack, or maybe to the chemist, who would give all sorts of, you know, creams, so-called concoctions, formulas, yes. And these are always, you know, not useful for the patient to be used. Now we have a, you know, outburst of the adverse effect because of the use of corticosteroid creams, topical corticosteroids, and this is a huge menace that the dermatologists are facing. And we must all educate our patients that the patients should not fall prey to the advertisements that are being there in the lay press or maybe media. They should first contact to their dermatologist, because the skin health is as important as the health of any other structure in the body. Now,
that because of the fungal epidemic era today,
yes,
we are facing, as a dermatologist, the side effect of the steroids or any irritant chemical applied by the patient, as well as we have to manage the fungal infection.
That's true.
So we have got double burden of treatment.
I entirely agree with you that the treatment, because of the, you know, actions from the patient, from the chemist, has become much more difficult and challenging for the dermatologist, as you know, it was not there in the past. Now, when we talk about the reactions to the oral medications, there have been several new molecules that have come into the market, and they have got potential to cause the drug reaction.
Yes.
Now, when it comes to the field of drug reactions, let me tell you that no drug is absolutely safe drugs.
Yes.
We only can have the safe physicians.
Yes.
A drug, if it can be used, it can be put to the use, it generally will have an adverse effect also. The degree of adverse effect may vary. So no drug is safe. That is something which everybody should realize. And basically, it's a double-edged sword. The drug can cause its useful effect as well as its harmful effects.
Another thing which I'd like to add in between, I'll disturb you in between.
No.
Because of the side effects, in our institution, in SMS Medical College, Jaipur, we have got a full-developed pharmacovigilance section.
Yes.
And it is our responsibility to report every side effect, that whichever we come across with any molecule, to the pharmacovigilance, because if we will report, then definitely it will be reported to the world literature, and that will be further helping to our fraternity.
Yes. You are very right that it is our responsibility, every physician's responsibility, to report all these adverse effects to the competent drug authorities.
Yes.
Now, when we talk about the drug reactions, now a clinician should be aware of the full spectrum of the adverse effects that the drugs can cause. Fortunately, most of the drug reactions are benign in nature. But many times, you can land up in what are called as serious or life-threatening drug reactions.
Yes.
Now, if you remember, there was an infamous case in the Apollo Hospital in West Bengal, in which a heavy fine was levied against the treating doctor.
Yes, that.
And probably that is some incidence for us to realize that how important the field of drug reaction is, and what should we know all about the drug reactions, and what are our responsibilities.
Another thing is, because if new molecule is coming and we have got drug trial of that in our institutions, at least in my institution, in SMH Medical College, I'm additional dean of the institution also. So we have got a very strict follow-up whenever a new molecule is used, and our ethics committee is very much aware of that. Then we tell the PI, principal investigator, any smallest side effect you report to us.
Yes.
And that has to be reviewed by a team of person who are member of ethics committee, and to be reported. Because initial stage in the drug trial, there happens to be some side effect, maybe mild, maybe moderate or severe or life-threatening, that has to be brought to the notice of the world also. So the precautions can be taken. Even certain group of population has got side effect with certain medicine, it cannot be generalized for every race. That part has to be also considered by us.
True. Now, when we talk about the drug reactions, there are some reactions which are relatively benign and of hardly any consequence.
Yes.
And then there are some reactions which are very serious. Now, as a clinician, what one should realize is to assess a patient properly and to see what is the gravity of the drug reaction.
Yes.
For example, if the drug reaction is very severe, like you have anaphylaxis, like if you have SJS or Stevens-Johnson syndrome, or toxic epidermal necrolysis, or AJEP, or acute generalized exanthematous pustulosis, the first and the foremost step for a clinician is to stop the drug immediately, assess the patient for the presence of internal damage, and then substitute a safer drug, which is sometimes very difficult to do, but this should be the aim of the overall management.
Yes.
Now, if the drug reaction is benign, then there is no need to panic.
Yes.
what we can do is, under observation, we can keep continuing the drug. Yes. And then if we feel that the drug reaction can turn into a sinister or serious rash, immediately stop the drug.
Yes, in the management of tuberculosis.
Yes.
When we are giving MDT for the tuberculosis,
yes,
we generally come across mild side effects.
Yes.
But we have to continue the anti-tubercular medicines,
yes,
keeping in view that our patient cure should take place, and mild side effects we can manage by another way. For example, acneiform rashes, if somebody gets with the isoniazid is such a medicine which kills the M. tuberculosis bacilli after going inside the cell.
Yeah.
Intracellular action is of this medicine only, and we cannot suggest a treating physician to stop the isoniazid. So we have to sometime watch the side effects, continue the medicine also.
Yes. So practically it is not very easy, yeah, to deal with such a cases of serious drug reactions.
Yes.
And what should, no, looking to that, you know, gap, what the IADVL gave us a opportunity or job to formulate a guideline, mm, on dealing with these serious kind of drug reactions. And in 2016, we came out with an Indian guidelines, mm, to deal with the serious reactions, particularly the toxic epidermal necrolysis and SJS. And this has been printed in the Indian Journal of Dermatology, Venerology and Leprology in the December 2016 issue. And this provides a very good guide about how to deal practically with the cases of serious adverse drug reactions. And coming on to the diagnostic part of these serious drug reactions, I would say that there is no single test that would, you know, tell you about the diagnosis of drug reactions. Basically, the diagnosis of drug reaction is purely clinical. It's a judgment that has to be made looking into the overall picture of the patient, the details of the drugs that the patient is taking, the temporal correlation of development of the reaction after the patient has taken the drug, and a past or the previous experience of the patient with that particular drug. Now, the guideline tells you about the best management that you should undertake as per the evidences that are available in the literature. Now, a important change that the guideline discusses about the management of toxic epidermal necrolysis is that earlier we used to use, you know, corticosteroids and IVIG as the first line of treatment.
Yes.
Now, the literature support and our own personal experience tells us that cyclosporine, which is a newer drug, is a very good drug to treat the patients with the toxic epidermal necrolysis, and it is now being routinely used by most of the dermatologists across India and the globe, and they are very happy with the results of cyclosporine, and the patients and physicians are very gratified after the use of cyclosporine in toxic epidermal necrolysis. But one must remember that since these are life-threatening reactions, we must always be able to tell to the patients that they need not to take this drug again ever in their life. So this is something that we must, you know, tell to them.
Again, a problem with the combination of medicines.
Yes.
If patient is taking 3-4 medicines,
that's a practical problem.
Again, yes.
That's absolutely.
And in that situation, the dermatologist has got another big responsibility. This drug is causing side effect.
Yes.
So in that case, what we have to do?
Yes. I think this is a very practical problem, and we have to see the, you know, patient from individual perspective.
Yes.
No two patients can be managed in the similar manner.
Yes.
You just have to see how much important the drug that the patient is taken,
yes,
is for that particular illness. Mm. If there are safer substitutes available,
yes,
it is better to substitute those medications with the safer substitutes and treat the drug reactions.
Yes.
Now, another point about the field is that patients have got a lot of misconception about the drug reactions. They most of the times hold the physician responsible for their drug reaction.
Yes.
Here I must, you know, make very clear that the reaction in a patient due to drugs is basically not any fault of the physician or clinician. I tell to my patients that this is the fault of your own body system, that this drug is not being tolerated by you well.
Even I like to suggest, whenever a patient comes with a side effect and he says about some physician that he has given this medicine has caused me this side effect, we have to tell patient it is not doctor at fault.
Yes.
It is your body mechanism, body biochemical reaction, body body's genetic constitution is responsible for the side effect. And doctor has given medicine to treat you, not to give you
a
sort of side effect.
Yeah.
So thank you very much, Lalit, and we.
So just we, you know, as a passing remark, we would just like to tell to everybody that one must always remember that there are no safe medications, but there are only safe physicians, and we should always try to become one of the safe physicians.
I invite all of you for DermaCon 2022 at Jaipur. And Jaipur is a pink city, and you will enjoy the good academic fees there as well as good environment and the points of sightseeing in Jaipur and Rajasthan. Padaro, padaro mare desh.
Padaro mare desh.